Hello everyone, this is an optional video to our big previous video about vulnerabilities of acoustic and radio frequency anti-theft systems, in which we told you and demonstrated various shielding materials and why there are several of them, why they evolved, changed, and why we began to use some for certain vulnerabilities and others for completely new protection systems and use them for modern systems of metal detection. This is the most modern and highest quality system of those with which we have faced people who exploit vulnerabilities of anti-theft systems. This system perfectly reveals metals, especially foil and other shielding metals, so you cannot calmly go through a similar detection system. Now I will connect it, and when I turn it on, this system passes an automatic process of settings, and now the visual indication will go off. That's it. The system is turned on. Why did they start to implement this system in stores, putting it next to the anti-theft systems? To protect themselves from such simple material like foil. And they managed. Metal detection system sees easily even a small amount of foil. This is just one little piece in one layer. But, for example, let's take from the previous video such foiled packages that are used in vulnerabilities. A little package will be visible only from point-blank range because of its format. Larger package is already noticeable anywhere. Why? To reduce the amount of false actuations on formats of smartphones in iron cases, small tablets, and so on. And if you have a large iPad with metal case, then something similar will happen. In the end, we bought this system in order to reveal its full vulnerabilities, and we did it. In 2016-2017, we chose the most perfect shielding material, to which even this modern system doesn't respond, in no way. This is particular fabric with specific reflection, characteristics of absorption signals. We showed it in the video, and now I'll tell you a little how we have come to it. Primary metal detectors were somewhat simpler and reacted exclusively to the foil, reducing the percentage of false responses, and were usually built in. They were primary metal detectors of sensor-matic and other built-in simple metal detectors. But time passed, and this shielding material, which was found and used in vulnerabilities of previous metal detectors, unfortunately ceased to be quality for those who exploit vulnerabilities. It was wonderful stuff, which we were using a lot during many years. Prior and at that time, we were checking a lot of these various shielding materials on other markets, on the market of China, Europe and the USA. We'd gone over about 20 or 30 types of various materials. This is Chinese material. Its characteristic feature is a structure resembling a small square. I will show you now. Here you can see. Squares. It's soft enough, but as you can see, most likely it is metallized. So it is. That is, given material is noticeable approximately as well as foil, and you do not even go with it this way. This is Chinese material. There was also similar, quite thin, metallized type from Europe, but it also detected instantly. There were checked materials of similar format from China, they were sold on the site AliExpress, and even in a small format, it is detected. It is known what they are made of. I already showed our material. If it is in this form, in this format, with our old material, we can still get through, but we increase the plane, and there is already a problem. After that, we realized that any materials that contain metal are useless. We started to search other conductive materials, other methods. We went through several types of carbon, and in the end, we came to carbon. But unfortunately, the following thing happens. Carbon materials have a certain structure. They have a certain density, and unfortunately, they reflect the signal and deform it. And that is not even the main problem why we did not choose it. The main problem is in its structure. It crumbles in the hands, threads loosen. It's impossible to sew it. And if you sewed and embedded it, eventually it crumbles into hands in your bag after a while. As a result, this is the fabric that we showed when working with radio frequency systems and exploiting its vulnerabilities. This fabric is effective to the maximum with radio frequency systems and with systems of metal detection. Again, to make it clear, it's just a little piece of foil. Be careful.